Welcome to our discussion on the law of demand in economics. In this video, I'm gonna explain deeper the law of demand and the reasons why demand curve is down and sloping. Okay, so let's begin. The law of demand is one of the most fundamental concepts in economics. It works with the law of supply to explain how market economies allocate resources and determine the prices of goods and services that we observe in everyday transactions. The law of demand states other factors being constant, or ceteris paribus, price and quantity demanded of any goods and services are inversely related to each other. Inverse relationship means price has an opposite or contrary effect to the quantity demanded, as shown in this graph. As we can see, when the price is up, the quantity demanded for the same product or service is down, and when the price is down, the quantity demanded is up. This makes the demand curve down and sloping. The question is, why does demand curve down and sloping? In other words, why is it that when the price for a particular product is up, the quantity demanded for the same product or service is down, and vice versa? Now, economists pointed out three reasons for this consumer's behavior. The first one is substitution effect. This is based on the idea that as the prices rise, consumers will replace more expensive items or services with cheaper substitution or alternatives, assuming income remains the same. Now, as prices increases for a good or service, we start to think of other products or choices that can satisfy us at a relatively lower price. Have you experienced changing your car insurance provider, for example, because of the lower premium offered by another insurance company? Have you experienced changing your favorite brand of grocery products due to price, or dining in a lesser expensive restaurant? Well, every time we do this, substitution effect is at work, right? So, the second reason why this consumer behavior that caused the demand curve to be downward sloping is income effect. In microeconomics, the income effect is the change in demand for a good or service caused by change in a consumer's purchasing power resulting from a change in real income. So this change can be the result of a rise in wages, or because existing income is freed up by a decrease or increase in the price of a good that money is being spent on. Let's analyze this further and try to understand this concept deeper. According to principle of income effect, if an individual gets a raise in income, he will also demand an increased amount of goods and services, so the quantity demanded is up. However, if an individual's income decreases, then so will his demand for goods and services, so the quantity demanded in this case is down. But how does price relate to income effect? How are changes in income related to prices? Well, let's say the price of your favorite cupcake is now 50 pesos from 100 pesos. So its previous price 100 pesos, now they're selling it at 50 pesos. The decrease in the price of cupcake increases the amount of money left from your paycheck with 50 pesos, okay? This 100 less 50 is 50 pesos. That amount now is called free money, which you can buy more cupcake or something else, which in effect, your quantity demanded for cupcake is up, increased. Now, inversely, if on the other hand, the price of cupcake increases from 50 to 100, meaning there's an increase of another 50 pesos, although or while the price increase in cupcake don't actually affect your paycheck, because whatever salaries you'll get, it's still the same. But it can make you feel like you have less money, and therefore it will cause you to buy less, which of course consequently means your quantity demanded for cupcake is down or up, is down. So that explains how and why income effect is one of the reasons why demand curve is down and sloping. The third reason, according to economists, is the law of diminishing marginal utility or decreased marginal utility. In economics, utility is the satisfaction, the happiness, the joy, or the benefit that's derived by consuming a product. Thus, the marginal utility of a good or service is the change in the utility from an increase in the consumption of that good or service. So as the utility of a product decreases as its consumption increases, consumers are willing to pay smaller amounts for each additional quantity of the same product. Okay? So let's work it out with our graph here. Let's take this y-axis here, or the price axis, for utility or satisfaction or happiness that consumers would get for each additional unit of the product that they will take or that they will buy. Now, assuming again that this product is cupcake, right? Now, you must observe here that for the first cupcake, the satisfaction level is very high. See this graph? But the satisfaction level decreases for each additional unit of cupcake being consumed. Because consumers derive less satisfaction from consuming additional units of a cupcake, they will only be willing to buy more of it if the cupcake's price decreases. In this way, the law of diminishing marginal utility helps explain why demand curve is down and sloping. All right, so again, there are three reasons why demand curve is sloping. In summary, number one, substitution effect. Number two, income effect. And number three, decreased marginal utility. That's it for this video. If you want to view another videos on the law of supply, shifters of supply and demand, and more about micro and macroeconomics, just visit my channel. And please don't just leave here without hitting the like, subscribe, and notification buttons below. See you in my other videos. Stay safe, everyone.